It was a name that sounded so sweet, so seductive. Synonymous with words, style, power. But that name was a curse too.
What a heartbreaking story, obviously. And one of the things I think that moved me the most, it's the scene where he's looking at his father saying, but this is the happiest I've ever been, when he's working for Patrizio's family. I don't know if you can answer this or not, but where is your happy place? Where are you happiest?
I don't have one thing. I'm probably happiest at home, but I'm really happy at work, you know? So I don't know, with my family, that's hard. There's not really one thing, you know, I don't get too lost in or pursuing happiness. I will say it, you know, cause it's immediately followed by the opposite. So it's not something I try to maintain. It comes in waves, and I'm always grateful.
Well, I don't know if press junket days are when you're happiest, because yeah. I know these are
right
tedious.
Here. Yeah, yeah. If I was in Phoenix, I would be the most
Thank
happy.
You.
But I would say my honest answer would probably be with my wife and my son. That for me is the. You know, there's no place I'd rather be.
Don't call me a cretin, sweetie.
That's not what I said.
Gaga has talked a lot about staying in character, and I think that you've done that a time or two before, but is that weird when somebody is in character, but maybe you have chosen not to be, and you're trying to, hey, it's me, Adam, now. I get it. You're Patrizia, but it's me talking to you. Is that ever strange?
Not really. I love it when, you know, there's great actors in this movie, and I don't think any one of us worked the exact same way. Everyone had a different way in, and also a different way in on based on what the scene was. And I don't judge or have an opinion about what anyone needs to do to get to the place they need to get to. My only prerogative is if, you know, what I love is that when we're there doing it, that, you know, and this is nothing that was said on set. There was like, I didn't say this. It just happens naturally with people who are great collaborators, is that they've done their work, but they're willing to throw it out in service of what you guys are working on in the moment. I find it weird. I find it focused, if anything. It may not be the way that I've chose to work on it, but like, That in a way pulls good, exciting things out of me, because I'm not expecting something.
You picked a real firecracker.
She's a handful.
You make this look so easy, and I know people are talking about how unrecognizable you are, but there were so many scenes where you add all of these random subtleties. The one that sticks in my mind is when Gaga is talking, the focus is on her, you kind of lean up against a wall and you almost question your stance. You're not even happy with the way that you're leaning. And I'm thinking to myself, do those subtleties come as you go, or are they pre-planned?
I appreciate you noticing that. And I remember it clear as day. And one of the things that's interesting about this film is usually you make a movie, it comes out a year and a half later. We just filmed this. So it's all really fresh and exciting to talk about. Those things, it's a combination. I tend to do a lot of improvisation, a lot of ad-libbing, but I come in prepared, because sometimes you can just destroy a scene, waste time, and things can go off the rails. So I do come in with a lot of preparation, a lot of ideas. And then, you know, when you work on character and you know that Paolo's the type of guy who he cares what other people think, and he's in a position there where he's kind of selling an idea, and you know, when he leans one way and then fixes it, it says something about the character. And, I had a lot of fun with this, as you can tell. And I absolutely fell in love with the character. I really enjoyed the opportunity. For me, it was just a dream come true.
Paolo, you are Gucci. You need to dress the part.
It's chic.
I just wanted to give him a hug the whole time. I just want to come in and go, no, your drawings, your designs aren't terrible. I just wanted to hug him. Have you ever had an idea where those closest to you, you were so excited about it and they just shot it down and really put you in your place?
Oh yeah, absolutely. It happens all the time. If you're trying a lot, you're going to fail a lot. And what's funny is sometimes people are right, but sometimes people are wrong. I mean, I've written songs and played them for people and they're like, "Nah, not my favorite one." And then released that song and it went on to be a hit, you know? So you got to trust your inner critic, your inner voice. But Paolo is a guy I really related to, you know, his desire to make something special and share it with the world. I spent a great deal of my life doing that. And, you know, he never really had the opportunity to be heard. And, you know, he's part of this giant dysfunctional family, which I think audiences around the world are going to have a lot of fun with this wild, crazy family. And I think a lot of people probably don't know this story of Gucci. I didn't even know it. And, you know, it's quite surprising and shocking.
Jeremy, what a pleasure. I'm Tara Hitchcock from Arizona, and I work with the largest family-owned theater chain in the U.S., and I'm just excited people get to see this exclusively at theaters on the big screen. Yeah.
Excellent, Tara. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, too. You know, you first see Rodolfo, and I remember thinking to myself, I would bet this is how Jeremy Irons dresses on a regular basis.
Ha!
Is that true?
No, not true. Not true. I have to tell you, I'm dressed up to the nines now because I thought, you know, I've got to speak to you and you'll be looking gorgeous, so I better dress well. But no, normally I'm in working clothes, whatever I'm doing, gardening or riding the horse or whatever. I don't dress like a mannequin, never have.
You know, there are so many great scenes involving you. Obviously, he is not a fan of who his son brings back to the house to meet him for the first time. Have you ever brought back somebody to the house, growing up or whenever, that your parents did not approve of?
And then yes, I have. I remember. Oh, nightmare. I remember bringing back auspicious. No, I don't know what. But anyway, right. And they were out.
Really?
And, yeah, and always going well until they came back a little bit early. I think I was about 15 or 16. And my stepfather, in fact, he was outrageous. He could immediately see that she was completely not who I should be with and started treating her like a princess. Said, oh, do come down, come and have a drink, come and sit down and let's, you know, oh, I was just dying in my... Yes, so I've been through that.
I don't know what it is about fathers and sons. There are some heartbreaking moments, not only with you and Adam, but with you and Jared. And you just want to give these boys a hug where your character, or Rodolfo, did not seem to provide them sometimes with what they really needed. Especially as it relates to Jared, where he just puts the kibosh on Paolo's dreams and aspirations. Were you ever in a position where you had an idea or you shared a dream with somebody close to you and they just nipped it in the bud and kind of deflated you?
I once wrote a script, the only script really I have written, and I sent it to a few people and they sort of damned it with faint praise. Mm. I should, of course, have just made it. But at that time, I thought I better get people's advice about whether this is any good. It is discouraging. It didn't break my heart because I'm an actor, not a writer. But looking back, I'm sorry that I asked anybody else. I think he should have just made his designs, as he eventually did. But it is heartbreaking to... I've had people who, I find it very difficult to say to someone who I've watched give an appalling performance that it was good. I find that very difficult. I try, but so, yeah.
You know what you can always say? Not my favorite, not your best work. That's a nicer way of saying not great.
Yeah. The lighting was wonderful. Yeah.
Yeah, there you go.
I subscribe to unconventional punishments.